Hey there, YouTubers. What's going on? How have you been doing? Yeah, so just got something on my mind, and currently running short on people with whom I can speak, with whom I can speak my mind. So, you know, about a bunch of things, about a bunch of topics. So here goes. You know, once again, it's about the poor relation, the relationship between between. Between Christianity and going midtown, and anti-natalism, like to share more insights and my own thoughts about that, and of course some with some references to the Bible. For crying out loud. Yeah, so I would like to share some some of my own thoughts, about porno, about fornication, about committing fornication and masturbating, fapping as a Christian. Should or should you do that? Well, yet in fact, I am a regular fapper myself, and I'm sure there are a whole bunch of other dudes and folks who either regularly or irregularly or intermittently fap and fornicate. Well, if you can't find a decent spouse, then why not fornicate? Though bear in mind, you will subject yourself to a bunch of you may subject yourself to a bunch of STDs, and you do stand a fairly high amount of chance in catching some of those STDs. If you are not careful, whether you believe in God or not, we all have to agree, that we should love ourselves. Well, unless you feel 100% ready without a single strand of doubt to commit suicide, to off yourselves. Well, if you have actually made up your mind, then then who am I to judge? Since I can utterly relate to to your despair and desperation and huge disappointment with this world and with the people, the world in this world, there are way too many self-righteous individuals, self-serving, righteous individuals, and there are a bunch of pastors, preachers, who constantly claim that they can somehow overcome their desire to fornicate or to commit some other sins. Well, we are all born sinners, and there is no there is no doubt about that. Even if you do happen to have some doubts about your salvation, about whether or not you are going to heaven, there's not a single strand of doubt that everyone sins. Everyone sins, you know, one way or another on a daily basis. No matter how frequently, how devoted you made yourself to prayers, to spiritual, to the so-called spiritual warfare, spiritual enlightenment, and holy communion with other, so-called brothers and sisters in Christ, who never cease to ignore you, who never cease to put you in a constant state of neglect and humiliation. And in the meantime, they claim. And they broadcast how decently, how righteously they've been living their lives. They've been doing whatever they can to please God. And actually, based on my experience with God so far, I don't suppose God will give a shit. Will give a freaking rat's ass. About how many good deeds you have done, as to whether or not you are saved, since it has nothing to do with whether or not you are saved, no matter how many good deeds you have done, but whether or not you have accepted Jesus, whether or not you have accepted, his blood shed on the cross to cover your sins and my sins and his sins and the rest of human individual sins and every unborn child. So let me please allow me to read the true gospel, the true saving gospel, not the four gospels, conventionally speaking, and it's a common misconception, and it's been preaching by the vast majority of churches throughout the whole world that you have to do what God tells you. You have to do what Jesus commands you, so that you can be saved. But that's totally crap. That's legalism, and no. As the Bible has already, said, has already foretold, no one can stop sinning. Everyone is a sinner. Everyone takes pleasure in sin, one way or another, more or less. And the true saving gospel lies in, the first epistle of Paul, the apostle, to the Corinthians, chapter 14, verses 1 to 4. Please allow me to read it aloud to you guys, if you don't mind. So, first Corinthians, chapter 15, verses 1 to 4. Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you, which also ye have received, and wherein ye stand, by which also ye are saved, if ye keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. For I delivered unto you first of all that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the Scriptures. If you continue reading, and that he was seen of Cephas, then of the 12, and after that he was seen of above 500 brethren at once, of whom the greater part remain unto this present, but some are fallen asleep. After that he was seen of James, then of all the apostles, and last of all he was seen of me also, as of one born out of due time. So You know, I just like to point out that nowadays everything has become quite evil, you know, quite messed up, and you know, we are, many of us are already on the verge of committing suicide. You know, for me, there's no, it's no different, unfortunately. And you know, so if you can find some ways to keep you, to keep yourself pleased, to keep yourself kind of glued to this freaking dog shit life, then why not indulge in some, you know, in some self pleasing behaviors like fapping and even fornication. And you know, and you don't have to, you don't actually have to please God to be saved. But I'm not actually I know I am kind of encouraging men to fornicate instead of finding a decent spouse to get married. But look around you. Can you find, a decent spouse? Can you find a someone who is even who fits in the definition of being a respectful person? I'm sure you know you'll find, you know, quite few. You know, it's pretty much nowadays every man for himself, not to mention every woman for herself. Everyone, you know, is doing something, you know, something dodgy, something, you know, even, you know, despicable, just to stay alive, just to stay financially afloat, free of debt. So, you know, if you can't, you know, get, if you can't, you know, keep your urges in check, and you wear a hat, and you wear an umbrella on your dick, and you take other precautions, then you know it's up to you. You know, it's after all, it is your life. It is your body, and I don't, you know, I'm not trying to, you know, to play God or trying to speak to you in a patronizing or condescending fashion. You know, unlike those pastors, unlike those, you know, preachers or so-called mentors or coaches, you know, they also make those videos to make some money. They make videos to you know, to increase the probability of standing to profit, to reap the you know, the benefits or the profits of their own teaching. And more often than not, they use, you know, God's words to, you know, to make themselves feel more superior to others, and you know, either deliberately or non-deliberately, they put us down. They put us down, or they put other people, in particular single men and mikdals, down to feel better about themselves. So you know, we all have blood on our hands. You know, we are all sinners. So what's to say, you know, he is better than you, or you are better than him, or you are a better person than, you know, than the rest? No, absolutely not. So and you know, going MGTOW, you know, doesn't actually, you know, conflicts or clashes with God's teaching. In fact, you know, Paul mentioned about staying single, if you can. You know, if you can stay single, and you know, but by all means. But if you can't, if you always you know feel your urges, then why not get married? I believe somewhere in the second epistle, Paul, the apostle to the Corinthians. Yeah. Where is it? Let me find it. Should be somewhere in chapter 6 or something. Let me find it. Paul defends his ministry. excuse me. I don't actually read the second epistle of Paul, the apostle to the Corinthians, very often. So, where did it go? Yeah, I can't find it. Maybe I should Google it instead. So, something about, you know, those who give in marriage do well. Those who don't give in marriage do better. Those who give in marriage do well. Something about, yeah. Corinthians, or this the first epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Corinthians, chapter 7. So, where is it? Yeah. Now concerning the things where ye wrote unto me, it is good for a man not to touch a woman. Nevertheless, to avoid fornication, let every man have his own wife, and let every woman have her own husband. Let the husband render unto the wife due benevolence, and likewise the wife unto the husband. The wife hath not power of her own body, but the husband, and likewise also the husband hath not power of his own body, but the wife. Defraud ye not one the other. Defraud ye not one the other, except it be with consent for a time, that ye may give yourselves to fasting and prayer, and come together again, that Satan tempt you not for your incontinency. But I speak this by permission and not of commandment, for I would that all men were even as myself. But every man hath his power. But every man hath his proper gift of God, one after this manner, and another after that. I say therefore to the unmarried and widows, it is good for them if they abide even as I. But if they cannot contain, let them marry, for it is better to marry than to burn. Blah blah blah. Yeah. Maybe there's something else here. Are you bound? Are you not bound? Seek not a wife. Somewhere, yeah. Still from, yeah, the second epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Corinthians. The first epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Corinthians, chapter 7. But it starts from verse 27. Art thou bound unto a wife? Seek not to be loosed. Art thou loosed from a wife? Seek not a wife. But if thou marry, thou hast not sinned. And if a virgin marry, she hath not sinned. Nevertheless, such shall have trouble in the flesh. But I spare you. Yep. And I want you to return to, you know, first Corinthians chapter 7, verse 7. Be fraudy not one the other, except it be with consent for a time, blah blah blah, you know. What if your wife defraud you, you know, so she won't have sex with you, and you know she even sometimes you know falsely accuses you of raping her, and sadly, you know, in throughout the rest of the Western world, including you know states like Belarus and you know blah blah blah, you know, they all have you know laws pertaining to marital rapes, you know, so-called marital rapes, What if you you got defrauded or denied of sex by your wife for so long that you can't contain yourself, and you know, so it sounds to me like you know a good cause to commit fornication, you know, to at least to fap, to fap to some porn or to bang a sex doll, even to fornicate. You know, even if First Corinthians chapter 6 verse 18 says, flee fornication, every sin that a man doeth is without the body, but he that committeth fornication sinneth against his own body. And then what know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? For ye are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. So don't you reckon that getting falsely accused of raping your wife can put you in a you know much worse situation than just going out and having a good time with a hooker, with a prostitute, and just you know pay the price once and for all. And you don't actually have to suffer, you know, a sentence from being accused of raping your wife within the confines of marriage. At least, you know, it's a reasonable choice for men now. Nowadays, you know, but for women, once they hit their walls, they will just become as disposable as men, you know. So I'm not saying God likes me doing it, or God likes you, you know, or God is pleased with you for fornicating, for going your own way. But isn't it better to fornicate than to commit suicide because you you know you got deprived of sex because you you got defrauded by your spouse, even got falsely accused of raping her within the confines of marriage. Well, I don't know, man. But I'm not married, so I can't say with absolute certainty, without a single strand of doubt, that that I will get falsely accused of raping my wife. But yeah, it's just freaking shit, you know. Why do you have to follow someone who also sins on a daily basis? Even you know, despite he or she is a pastor or a preacher, and never ceases, you know, to tell you not to sin, to please God by not sinning. But you still sin, you know, even, you know, you still sin one way or another, even if you don't commit fornication, even if you don't, you know, even if you don't fap to porn, you still sin on a daily basis. So what's the point of not sinning? So what's the point of trying your utmost best not to commit any sin? Well, there are more detestable sins and less detestable sins, you know. So if you turn to a fag, if you turn a homo, it's definitely a more despicable sin than fornicating with the woman. Yeah, so if I have to choose between rape and fornication, I will choose fornication for sure. Yeah, so I'll leave you to judge the rest. Well, I'll leave you to judge for yourselves. Anyway, guys, I suppose I have already talked enough, since I am beginning to repeat myself again and again and again and again, over again in this video. Yeah, so take care and try not to commit suicide. Yeah, have a great day.